Good morning, everyone, and this is John, and it's time for devotions. Happy New Week to you, and I hope and trust and pray that God will bless your week and that your week will be filled with cheer and filled with God's richest blessings. How are you doing? Are you still coping? Are you still fine? And yes, how is your health holding up? Well, with all the rain we had yesterday, it's really wonderful just to know that God has given us this rain. And we know with rain comes life, and we see the trees in bloom. It's absolutely just wonderful. And we are constantly reminded that God is in control and that we are His creation and that He takes care of us. But let's have a look. Let's have a look at the Word of God today and let's see what He has to say to each and every one of us. Our reading today comes from Paul's letter to the church in Ephesus, Ephesians chapter 6, verses 11 and 12. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realm. Folks, what I want to speak about this morning is something that we as people do not like speaking about, and that is about the devil. You know, we do not like acknowledging that he's around, and we don't like acknowledging that he is out there to tempt us and to distract us from the wonderful love of God and our reconciliation to God. Paul writes here and he says, you know, our struggle is not against flesh and blood. In other words, we do not struggle with one another and we do not struggle with people, but our struggle is with the devil. Our struggle is with his temptation and how he tempts us and tries to mislead us just so that he can separate us from the wonderful grace and salvation that God has given to us as a gift. You know that we don't like talking about it, and it's scary to some of us, but whether we like it or not, there is a spiritual realm, and in that spiritual realm there is the forces of evil that are constantly trying to fight the good, trying to fight God's plan, trying to fight God's angels, trying to fight us so that we can be distracted. Now, we must never underestimate the devil. Although he is under our authority, we must remember that he's out and out there to get us. And you know what? The worst part is that he knows us so well. He knows every step that we take. He knows our weaknesses. He knows where our hearts are soft and to what they are soft. And he knows who we love. And he knows who we cherish. And the worst is he uses those to get to us. He uses those that we love so much to get to us by creating a confusion within our minds so that we may have, cannot use a simple term or a common language, so that we may have a fight or an argument with those that we love so much, just so that we cannot live in harmony and so that we cannot live the way God wants us to live and the way that God leads us. Remember, it's the devil's way to try and go against everything that God teaches us. And the greatest thing that God teaches us is to love one another and to love God with all our hearts and our minds and our souls. And we must never forget that God said to us, or Jesus said to us, that we must love one another as Jesus has loved us. And how did he love us? He loved us so much that he died for us. He sacrificed his life for us. Folks, we must always question in our struggles. We must always question, is this what Jesus would have done? Is this in line with his scriptures? Is it in line with what the Holy Spirit teaches us? Is it in line with bringing honor and glory to God? And if you have to answer that and you honestly can say no, then you know it's not from God. And this is the devil trying to tempt us and trying to mislead us and take us away from God. We must be careful when we read this text, because it says we must be careful of the rulers and we must be careful of the authorities. But we must also remember these are the rulers and the authorities of the dark world we live in. It's not necessarily our government. It's not necessarily our municipalities and our council members and our ward members and the different ministers in cabinet. No. It is the people who promote going against God. Remember, I spoke about morals and ethics and that type of thing last Sunday in the worship service. And I said, beware that we don't conform to societal standards, but rather that we conform to the ethics and the morals and the values of the Bible. Remember, I used the example of divorce and how, according to communal ethics, it's okay to get divorced. But it goes against scripture and it goes against what Jesus teaches us. So we must be careful that we don't confuse the two. And you see, it's because of the community, the people themselves, that promote that it's okay to get a divorce. And who are those people? Those are people just like me and you that live in the community and say, you know what, it's acceptable, it's fine, it's okay. Now those are the dark rulers and the dark people of this world that want to bring secularization into our faith. And sure, that's a big word, secularization. But all that it means is that we want to make our faith, we want to make our relationship with Jesus the same as what it is in the world. And we know that it's been a struggle throughout the whole of Scripture. Do not do as the world does, but rather do as Jesus does. The greatest thing of all is that Paul starts this today's pericope. Remember what a pericope is? Passage of Scripture. He starts this pericope in verse 11 by saying, God has clothed us with his full armor. Now, what does armor do? Armor was put on in the old days so that when they stabbed you with a sword or stabbed you with a knife, it could not pierce your body, it could not harm you, because it protected you and it was made of a very strong metal, iron mixed with bronze or whichever they used. And it's that armor that protects you, and God gives us that armor to protect us against the devil. And how does he do that? He does that by giving us the Holy Spirit, that gives us a spirit of discernment that we can discern, so that we may know this is wrong. This is not God's way. This is not what God wants from us. And Paul warns us here, and he says, he has clothed us, we must use it. So folks, don't be misled. Don't let the devil mislead you, but question everything you do, question everything you say, and make sure that with your actions, with your words, that you will be bringing honor and glory to Almighty God, and that we can love one another through his guidance. Amen. We've heard God's word to us this morning. Come, let us come before him and ask him to help us. Come, let us pray. Gracious Lord and Heavenly Father, Lord, we've heard your word to us, Lord. And yes, Lord, we've heard and we heed the warning that you've given to us. Yes, as Paul has said to us, our battles are not with one another and with other people, but it's against the darkness and it's against the powers of evil. Oh Lord, you clothe us with the armor to protect us against this. And Lord, this morning we want to ask you to please help us with this, because we are very weak and we are very easily misled. Oh Lord, we are gullible and we just fall for every trick in the book. And therefore, Holy Spirit, we want to ask that you will open our eyes and that you will give us that spirit of discernment, that we may discern between right and wrong, and that we may follow and bring you all the honor and the glory, dear Lord God. So, Lord, we pray that you will help us in this regard and make us aware of all the evil that is around us, so that we may surely serve you. Oh Lord, we thank you for this wonderful new week you've given to us. We thank you for this wonderful new day. We thank you for the wonderful rain that you've given to us, because we know with that rain comes new life, Lord, and it is only you that can bring that new life. So Lord, as we come this morning, thanking you for being with us, thank you for taking care of us, we also want to pray, Lord, that you will go through this week with us, that you will touch each and every one of us, and that you will bless us, and that you will be with us. O Lord, we praise you and we worship you. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Folks, once again, our time together has come to an end. Our devotions are always so special to me, but it's even more special in bringing you God's word there wherever you may be. There where you are, in your home, at your work, or in your business. I thank you for spending this time with you, and I thank you that you've allowed me in. But as this week progresses, I wish you God's richest blessing, and that you will always remember that he's there with you, no matter what. So until we meet again, stay safe, stay healthy, and always remember that Jesus is there for you. We close today with that wonderful hymn, Stand Up for Jesus. So until I meet with you again, goodbye now.